For the entire course, only one business person. So he is covering step by step all the CFD models.
Okay, sir. Fine, sir.
So if the first session, if you are giving in the sense, somebody felt that I don't know how to mesh.
Okay, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Correct. Yesterday we were seeing, yes, sir.
So that problem will be somebody may give some different types of input. So
okay,
a single person in a MVP, we can get a single feedback.
Okay, then, sir.
Assignment, what now felt in the sense, last MVP, we are sending every day some objective types of question. Now, directing the objective question is the people are just gathering from a net or something and giving some answer like that. Why don't you give a workshop? This is a workshop. You have to give some type of assignment differently. That is, I have to do the what they have learned, like in a PPT, how to collect and then store in a G-Drive.
Okay, sir.
That is, we are planning, sir. For submitting assignment, you can take 1 week.
Okay, sir. Is it MCU, MCQS, sir, or
in between, we frame a question and then send it to through email.
Okay, sir.
Then you have to take a 1 week time, and
okay,
then
okay.
Within that one, within that. We finalize the qualified persons in the utterance wise qualified persons and preferred a certificate. The certificate is not like an auto generated certificate. Here, the manually, the utterance checking, because we purchased the Zoom control is somebody's having a control. They will check that utterance every day.
Okay, so, sir.
They will send the eligible candidate. For that
okay,
one,
sir.
You can generate a certificate.
So, fine, sir. Fine, sir. Fine, sir.
That is the matter, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Just now, somebody has entered with application of science. The attendance will be not marked for application of science.
Hello, sir. Yeah, tell me, sir.
Yeah, you are entering your name as application of science.
Okay. I actually, my name is Vishnu Karthik, sir.
You come to your name itself.
Okay, okay.
I just remove you. Mom, remove you. Mom.
Okay, okay, sir.
Sir, welcome, sir. Good morning, sir. Welcome to the today's function. Sir, welcome. Your audio is not clear. Your audio is not clear, sir. Not audible, sir. Not audible, sir.
Now it's okay. You are able to hear me?
Yeah, we are getting that audio, sir.
Whether the sound is less or more, okay, it's fine.
It's fine, fine, sir. Fine, fine.
Because I'm not using my mic and speaker, so I hope it's not a problem.
Now it's okay, sir. Now it's okay. It's clear and audible.
Yeah, yeah, fine. Just 2 minutes. I'll try to log on through another system also, so that I can share whatever I'm going to write. Just a minute.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Please mute your system.
Hello?
It's audible, sir.
Okay, fine. Enjoy. Ready.
Sir, you are entering into some admin now.
I have requested for another login.
Yeah, it's coming, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, both are connected.
Yeah, fine, sir. Yeah, I got it.
Sir, the second one is not meant for audio. I think audio is okay.
If it's visible, whatever, you can share in the second one, the notebook.
Sir, you have to mute the another user one. Another phone. You have to mute that one. That is sound volume you have to decrease because that's echoing. Again, you can speak, sir. You can test. Till volume is there.
No, the problem is. Is okay. Once sir, you can simply share the screen of this second one.
Okay.
I hope.
Okay, sir. We can start. We can see that one, sir. How it's.
I want you to share the screen of that particular thing and another ID. This one I want to share. Okay, I will try.
So you can start.
No, sir, I have to share with that only. There only I can teach.
The second one, sir?
Yeah, second one. Others wait, sir. I will try. Sir, I will try. Okay. Stop here. Then share. No. Some other participant is trying to. Please, all of you can stop sharing your screen. I can try here.
How will you store the money? Yeah.
Sir, you have login in two devices, sir. Please, can you decrease the total volume of any one device, sir?
Sir, you can allow me to share the screen. Yeah.
So your voice is echoing, sir.
It's a mobile screen.
That's not the thing. I have to share the video actually.
Okay.
Yeah, I was able to see the screen.
Sir, if you can start camera on your mobile phone, then we can see the paper you are writing on.
Yeah. Camera only started already.
Sir, the normal camera, your Android camera.
Yeah. I'm also looking the same. I'm also looking the same.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, sir. If possible, we can use Whiteboard, sir. Whiteboard is a tool which is available in Zoom. We can just click on share screen and use Whiteboard so that we can directly write on Whiteboard.
In this, your share screen, sir. We'll select in the share screen. He told that something iPhone, iPad. Some icon is coming, sir. That's why the professor is telling. You can directly connect that phone using a Wi-Fi mode. Instead of the two entry.
Yeah. Now I hope you can share my this particular screen, sir. If everyone able to see the white paper on your screen.
Yes, sir.
You are able to see.
But
No, sir.
That much.
Sir, unmute your mobile phone and mute the computer. Things.
No, don't worry about the voice now. I will tell the necessary remedy. Now you just check whether the whatever I'm writing here is visible there.
No, sir.
In the screen.
No, sir. It's not visible. Not visible, sir.
Whether you're able to see.
No, it is visible. No, sir. But it's separate login.
It's visible. Separate login, sir. So
no,
there are two names under you, sir.
In the enter screen.
Sir, only we seeing you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Sir, in the...
Sir, only we seeing you.
Sir, we can only see the people who are speaking. So, if you unmute that...
Sir,
just a minute.
When you write in the paper, when you if you unmute that mobile login, sir, we can easily see you, sir.
Already, I unmuted my mobile. It's been done long back. If everyone is putting in unmute mode, this problem of sound will not be a problem. Now, not to zoom the paper. Now, the problem is just to see the other screen. Yesterday, I tried it.
So, you can try the share screen with your phone, sir.
Okay, just a minute. I'll come back. So now everyone can move to my second screen, not to my screen where my face is visible. You go to the another screen where the paper is available. You can do by going to the participants, then click on my second host.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Okay. We did it, sir.
You are getting?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you put it is Tundil Karparaj 2. Yeah. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Double click on the screen, you can use it. Double click on the screen.
Where the paper is there?
Yeah. It's right on the CFD.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine.
Okay, sir.
Sir, can you tell me once again, sir, how to do that?
So, everyone is able to visualize?
Sir, can you tell me once again?
In the view form, multiple gallery view form, you have to select Tundil Karparaj 2.
Yeah.
In gallery, sir?
The gallery view form. Alt F2.
Okay, sir. Alt, okay, sir.
Alt F2. You can get what are the participants in the meeting.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That I'm getting, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. From that Tundil Karparaj 2.
Double click that one, sir.
You have to make it that one, sir. That is full screen.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay.
Okay.
So everybody is able to see, please.
Remaining people, unmute the mic.
Yes, sir, able to.
Yeah, without that, it's very difficult to teach now. Otherwise, you can do one other thing. Go to participants. You go to participants, they're down. My name will be there as Tunal Kapadhi 2. There you click once again. Okay, everybody is able to get it. Shall we move?
You can move, sir.
Okay. But I am unable to visualize. Yeah, I'm able to get it. Now what we can do means everyone can put the phone in mute mode. Except me. Now to avoid echoing only, everybody please put your phone in mute mode. Sir, Perisami, sir, you also may put in mute mode. So we'll try. Yeah, he has also put in.
Definitely, sir. I'm
okay. Yeah. It also is in mute mode only.
So participants are not in mute mode, sir.
Which one? My mobile is in mute mode only.
Yes, sir. You are in mute mode, sir. One more participant. Huh? Name is Abhinav Parvat. He is not in mute, sir.
Just a minute.
The participant name Siva Murgam K. Sir, I request you to mute your radio, please. Siva Murgam K. Yeah, thank you.
Hello? Hello, if it's
there. Yeah, it's hearing.
Is there?
Ah, yeah. You can go ahead, sir.
But it's echoing, now. I hope it is not there.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Hello. Sir, the reason for we use two devices, that why echo problem will arise, sir.
No, everybody can put in a mute mode. So yesterday I tried,
sir,
it was not echoing.
Now you can activate two devices, sir. Hello? Yeah.
Sir, you can cut your speaker in mobile phone, sir. There is an option in the top left corner, a speaker symbol. You can cut it off.
Already it is in echo mode. It is unmuted mode only.
Sir, you can cut the speaker out, sir, from your mobile device. There is a top option in the top left. A speaker symbol will be there, sir. You can cut your output from the mobile phone.
I hope it is okay for everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, fine. I will proceed. Today, I am going to teach about the importance of CFD with respect to the governing equations. Governing equations. It is like this. Yeah, I hope it is visible now. And this is the governing equation what we are going to derive. Yeah. Yes, now we can see, I can take a control volume. This control volume is fixed in space, and another control volume is going to move in space. Okay, and enough number of fluid particles passes through it.
Sir, please share the screen, sir.
Already in scare mode.
Sharing mode only. You are in number, what's your name? Sharing mode only. Yeah. Purpose 2. We have to click that one. Share is in the sharing mode only. So you can continue, sir.
You can either take from gallery view or you can go to participants. In there, my name will be at the bottom. It will be Thundil Karpada 2. If you are going to click that one, you can see the shared screen. Yeah, I'm using two logins. The first login where my video will be available. The second login where whatever I'm sharing the screen will be available.
Sir, can you say please the login name, sir? Second login.
No, Samudra has taken the SAS screen. Yeah, yeah. Please tell me.
Look, yeah, can you say the second login name?
Somebody is mailing there.
Thundil Karparaj 2.
Yeah, go to participants. In there, you can put as Thundil Karparaj 2. If everyone is able to get it, shall we proceed?
Yeah, proceed, sir.
Yeah, fine. Now we can see there's a control volume is there. This control volume is fixed in space. Control volume is fixed in space. Whereas this control volume is going to move. So both are control volumes. More videos are there. Yeah. Okay, fine. So it is a control volume moving in space. Whether whatever the word is I'm writing is clear to you?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay, I'm not able to get properly, but everyone is able to get means I'm happy. Yeah, okay, fine. So I'll move further. Yeah. And another thing is, yeah, first we'll have these two control volumes. The first one is the control. I'll go with the board, the paper one. Yeah. So this control volume is fixed. And we are going to assume the flow is going through this control volume. So you may think why. Okay, fine. So you can go to this control volume. And we can see a number of fluid particles is passing through this control volume. And in the second case, the same fluid particles are passing through the control volume, but the control volume is also moving. The control volume is not fixed. The control volume is moving. So when the control volume is moving, what is the difference between this control volume fixed and control volume moving? Anyone can tell me?
So the relative motion will not be there when the control volume is moving along with the fluid particles. CV will be moving at the same speed as that of the instantaneous velocity of the fluid motion.
Just a minute, I could not have here.
Sir, mass is fixed. Mass is very.
Hello, sir. Laminar flow, sir.
Mass.
Mass is fixed. Mass is very.
Lagrangian island. ಮೈಕ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿಸೋದಿಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ
ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮಿನರ್ ಫ್ಲೋ
ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್
ಸರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಯುವರ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸುಂಡಿಲ್ ಸರ್
Sir, are you speaking?
Is there? Hello. Brother, I'm audible now.
Yeah, now audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I cannot hear them.
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. Hello. Hello, you can speak out now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now your voice is audible to me. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, what's the difference between this one and that one?
Mass is fixed.
Lagrangian mode and Eulerian mode.
That is formula. Everybody can tell Eulerian Lagrangian, but I want, yeah, somebody has typed something. I got the answer, what I want. Actually, in Lagrangian, I can go to the chat box and see, yeah. Put this one, Lagrangian, yeah. Yeah, very good, very good. I got from Oscar, is from Singler. Yeah, yeah, I got the answer from him. All are right only. But the problem is, I want very simple answers only. I don't want a complicated answer because I don't know who is Lagrangian and who is Eulerian. Okay, I know only control volume. Now this control volume, when it's going to be fixed, at one instant of time, some amount of molecules can enter and some amount of molecules may leave. At some other instant of time, you can see more amount of molecules may come and more amount of molecules may leave. So the flow rate through the control volume is not going to be fixed when you are going to have the control volume to be fixed, when it's not going to move. On the other hand, when you are going to have the control volume to be moving in space, the beauty of this control volume is that it will always have the same particles. It will always have the same particles, that is, mass is fixed. Rajik, here the mass need not to be same. Some amount of mass may come in, some amount of mass can leave away. But in the second case, when you're going to have, we can see that the mass will remain fixed. The mass will remain fixed. That is what I want. Now, what is the second difference you found out? The first difference is, as I told, here the mass will be, the first case, the left-hand side, the mass will remain varying. In the second case, the mass will remain fixed because the control volume is moving in space. Control volume is moving in space. What are the other differences you can tell me? What are the other differences you can point out? Relative motion, that's fine. I am not asking anything very high funda. Whatever I'm going to answer will be very simple and silly only, but that is very important.
Yeah, sir. We can simply say first one is like a heat transfer, second one is like a aerodynamic analysis.
No. Now I have considered the fluid. All of you, please let us assume that we are considering the flow through a pipe. Okay, so that it will be easy for you to understand. Now let us take a normal pipe. In that normal pipe, we are going to assume the flow is going to happen from the left end to the right end. In this, I want to study about the fluid properties which is going through the pipe. For that, what I am going to consider means, I am going to consider two things. One is control volume, which is going to be fixed in space. And for the other, where the control volume is going to move in space. Okay, both these control volume are not there in the fluid flow. I'll once again tell you, it's only our imagination. Now the flow is happening through the pipe only, from the left to the right end. But in order to study CFD, we are going to imagine, a control volume is there inside the pipe. And this control volume is not fully through the pipe. It may be small also. Small control volume, through this control volume, we are going to see that some particles may come in and go out. That is the left-hand side. In the right-hand side, what I am about to tell is that here the control volume is also about to move along with the fluid from the left-hand to the right-hand. So I can tell the left-hand side where the control volume is fixed is like a traffic police. He will stand in a particular place and you will see some people are coming into his signal and will be leaving the signal. At some instant of time, some people may come. At some other instant of time, more people may come. I hope you got the meaning. And in the second case, it's like a police who used to catch the thief. So the thief is going doing some things and the police is going to catch him. So he's going to go back behind him. That is nothing but the control volume is what? Is fixed, but the control volume is moving. The mass is fixed, but the control volume is moving. So for this, I want some basic differences. The first difference what I told is, in the first case, the mass will not remain fixed. In the second case, where the control volume is moving, the mass will remain fixed. Now my second question is, what are the other differences you can frame between these two diagrams, where the control volume is fixed and the control volume? Don't talk about boundary condition. Here I have not defined any boundary condition. Boundary condition is at the left end and the boundary condition is at the right end. But through the center only we are discussing.
Sir, that means the solid particle is moving.
Hello?
Yes, solid particle is moving.
It's not solid, it's a fluid. Whatever we are going to discuss is the fluid only. So we are assuming, you please, all of the participants, you please listen, that we are considering a flow through a pipe, through a hollow pipe or a tube. Now the flow is happening from the left end to the right end. There's no control volume really. In real situation, there's no control volume. But for studying the purpose of CFD, I am assuming, I am imagining there's a control volume in one case. In the other case, I am going to imagine a control volume is going to move. Okay, but practically speaking, there's no control volume at all. Okay, in the real physics, there's no control volume at all. The flow will enter on the left hand side, leave on the right hand side.
Sir, some bubbles.
Some bubbles. You tell me.
Some bubbles. Bubbles is moving. Bubbles.
It's not bubbles. Water flow. Actually, you open a tap, water will be flowing. It's not opening into the atmosphere. You can't be a tube or a pipe. You imagine like that. That's it. Don't assume bubbles. It's a water liquid particle. Bubble means it's vapor. Energy is conserved, I agree. Both the cases, energy will be conserved. No, I am asking very simple and silly questions. My answers are not very big like what you are thinking. Vortex central very, very high. Cavitation central very, very high. I am not that much good in cavitation and other physics.
Pressure
difference will be same. If you go to MA, no second law, Moses is satisfied. Yeah, momentum will be there.
Mixer, fluid mixer is there, mixing some other kind of fluid is mixed in it.
The turbulence laminar.
No, that's what I'm telling. Don't think too much. I am not that much good like you. I am very typically I'm a layman. I'm a small kid, like that you feel. Don't think by beyond conduction, momentum equation, turbulence, cavitation. These are all beyond my knowledge. You assume I'm a 10th standard student. Then you tell me. The first difference, can you get it? What the first difference I told? What are the first difference I told you?
Control value.
No, what are the first difference I told you?
Mass is fixed.
Mass is fixed in the second case. Assume the control limb is fixed, a central limb is moving, but the mass inside that is fixed. That is on the right hand side. This one. Yes. This one, where I put a tick mark, the control limb is moving.
The mass is conserved.
In both the case, mass is conserved. I will tell, because the mass is conserved is based on at inlet and outlet. But what the control limb you see here is in the middle of the session. The first difference what I told is, in case of the moving control volume, the mass inside the control volume will remain fixed. The mass through the control volume where it is fixed, where the control volume is fixed, the mass will not remain constant, the mass will be varying. So the left hand side, mass will be varying through the control volume. That's the logic. The right hand side, the mass is fixed. This is the first difference I told between these two control volumes. The left hand side is what? Mass is varying. The right hand side is what? Mass is fixed. My question is that, can you give some more difference like this? Somebody asked me, sir, the question is not clear. I am telling the question once again. The left hand side, the mass is varying through the control volume. The right hand side, the mass is fixed through the control volume.
Sir, varying, sir.
Huh?
For moving CV, the pressure difference will be there.
Sir, density.
Closed system and open system.
Yeah, you are coming closely. You are now only stepping down from 100% to 60 or 40. I am at a 10% level. I am not still that much good.
Control volume, shape change.
Control volume is?
A1 is equal to rho 2, A2, V2, sir.
Yeah, that is applicable. If I'm going to cancel the flow to be compressible, then rho 1, A1, V1 equal to A2, V2. That's another fine. Don't go too much. You see, whenever I told some difference, I never used any equation, isn't it? I told simply mass is fixed, mass is varying.
Control volume size change.
Very good, very good, very good. Who is that person? Really,
I'm not. IIT.
From IIT?
Madras 2003 batch.
Oh, really great to say. Really great to see. Thank you, sir. Thank Actually, what is happening here? In the second case, the shape of the control volume may vary. The shape is what? I can write it here. Yeah. Afternoon, I will try to buy a board. So it is now somewhat difficult. So I want to manage. Shape can vary. Here, in this first case, shape is fixed. I can't change the shape of the control volume in the first case. In the second case, where the control volume is moving, I can change its dimension. I can change its dimension. I can change some place where the control volume is moving, it can become small. In some other place where the control volume is moving, I can make the control volume to be what? It can grow in size. So we give the advantage for this control volume which is moving in space to change its shape. Whereas the control volume which is fixed in space, it can't change its position, it can't change its volume, it can't change its water, space also. Got the logic what I'm telling? Shape also. If everyone is clear? So whatever the difference I want is simply when a control volume is fixed, the mass through the control volume will vary. But its shape and volume will remain constant. On the other hand, if I'm going to assume there's a control volume which is going to move along with the flow, its mass will always remain constant. That means it will always have the same fluid particles inside it. But this fluid particles will try to move here and there. So I am giving this opportunity or the freedom to this control volume to change its shape. It can increase or it can decrease. Its volume can increase or its volume can decrease. So I hope everyone is clear. I don't want to talk about control mass or open control volume technique and all. I am not that much good. I will explain as a layman to everyone. Okay? Yeah, that's what I also told earlier. So whenever I'm explaining, I will explain just to, I'm speaking to a 10th standard or 12th standard. Then gradually, I'll be stepping up. So now, I hope you got the logic. And whenever you're going to derive the governing equations, whenever I'm going to derive the governing equations, based on this control volume, what type of equation will be? I'm going to derive kinetic equation. I'm going to derive momentum equation. I'm going to derive energy equation based on these two control volumes. Either I can take the control volume, just fix it, or the control volume is moving. Either the control volume is fixed or control volume is moving. Now you tell me what type of governing equations I'll get. Integral, you have to answer form. Me. Huh?
Integral form.
Yeah, we'll be getting the integral form of the governing equation. Yesterday itself I told, if I'm going to use a control volume technique, then the resultant form of governing equation will be integral form. On the other hand, if I'm going to use a fluid element, then the resultant form of governing equation will be of differential form. Will be of what? Differential form. So let us move further. Since I can't make it here, I will move to this page. Yeah. So now I am going to, actually should be drawn the same page, but the video is not able to cover. So I'm going to take it to this page. Here I'm going to draw the same thing, but instead of a control volume, I'm going to take a fluid element. Okay, so now the flow is happening through the fluid element. And on the other side, this fluid element is going to move. So it's going to move some velocity. So the fluid cannot enter in, or the fluid cannot leave from this control volume. Sorry, not the control volume, the fluid element. So this is the fluid finite element, or the fluid element. Fluid element, here it is fixed in space. Here the fluid element is moving in space. So anyone can tell what is the difference between the fluid element fixed in space and moving in space? The same thing what we discussed for control volume. Please make it fast.
What's the difference will be there, sir?
Huh?
Pressure difference.
I'm going to kill you, all people. What I told you for control volume, you had just followed for fluid element.
Fluid particle size will be reduced. Fluid particle size will be reduced.
No, that are all fine. I am asking the similarity between the control volume and the same here also. Fluid element also.
Mass is conserved, energy
is. Yeah, that's what I. Now, don't tell mass is conserved. Once again, you tell the proper word. In both the cases, mass is conserved.
Input mass equal to output mass.
No, please.
Mass is entering equal to mass.
I'm not happy with you. I'm not that much good
mass
person
entering,
like you.
Mass entering the system is equal to mass leaving them.
Which is called as, I never use the word called system. Which one you are referring to?
Control mass.
The word unnecessarily.
Mass of the fluid element remains constant. Mass of the fluid element remains
constant.
That's it. Not the same thing only I'm telling you. The mass of the moving fluid element remains constant. Please, all of you understand, there are certain mass of fluid particle inside this fluid element. That will always remain fixed. That's what I want. I don't know mass is conserved. I don't know system.
Yeah, velocity fixed. Picture velocity.
Huh?
Velocity, yeah. Is fixed.
I'm going to kill you once again. Whether I spoken about velocity in the last case. please be very clear. Let us not waste the time. You are more brilliant than me, so that only the problem arises. I am not so brilliant like you. You teach me, you take me just a layman. So once again, I'm telling, in the moving fluid element, the mass will remain fixed. Mass remain fixed means what? The mass inside the fluid element is a constant, or the same amount of mass will be there in your thing. Otherwise, I can tell you like this. I want to travel from Chennai to Coimbatore. Okay. Then, if the same number of patches is there from Chennai to Coimbatore, it is called as your moving fluid element. No person will get down at Katpadi or they will not get down at Salem. So, the same number of people will be there at Chennai, as well as the same number of people will be dropping at what? Coimbatore. In the other case, it's like a bus where some people can enter at Vellore or some people can drop at Salem. So, it's like that. The mass can vary. The mass can vary through the fluid element. The mass can vary through the fluid element. Is known as what? Your fluid element fixed in space. In the other case, when the fluid element is moving, it should hold the same mass. The mass should not change within this fluid element. Got the logic, what I'm telling? Whether it's clear, it is same as that of control volume. It is same as that of what? Control volume. I'm not doing anything. Instead of a control volume, here I have taken a fluid element. When the fluid element is going to be fixed in space, some number of particles may enter, some number of particles may leave. The mass through this control fluid element need not to be constant. At one instant of time, some amount of molecules can enter. At some other instant of time, more amount of molecules may enter. Some amount of time, some instant of time, the mass can still vary. But when a fluid element is going to move in space, its mass will always remain constant within the fluid element. Within the fluid element, the mass will remain fixed. Are everyone okay? What is the second difference? So here mass is fixed. Here the mass is varying through the fluid element. Whatever I'm talking is through the fluid element only. Don't assume outside. Don't assume inlet and outlet and all. Whatever I am speaking here is only through the fluid element. So here through the fluid element, the mass can vary. Here through the fluid element, the mass is remain fixed because no mass can enter in or no mass can leave out of the fluid element in the right hand side. Okay, it's fixed. What is the second difference then? The same as that of control volume.
Non-deformable control volume. The control volume doesn't change in size.
Yeah, very good. Which will be remain fixed, which will be varying?
In the left hand side, the volume doesn't change, but in the right side, due to some changes, it can vary in size.
Very good, very good. Thank you. You saved me. Yeah, in the right hand side, the fluid element may change its shape and volume. In the left hand side, since it's fixed, the fluid element should not change its shape. Very good. So the fluid element shape and volume remains constant or fixed. Here, fluid element shape may vary. It has the rights to change. My handwriting is not okay, but I hope you can understand. Yeah, fine. Now, we have considered four different things. One is the control volume fixed in space, the control volume moving in space. The second thing is fluid element fixed in space, and the fluid element is moving in the space. Okay. My question is now, what will be the type of governing equations you will get when you are going to consider the fluid element instead of control volume? I will repeat the question once again.
PD.
Yeah. What is the answer somebody have told?
Difference finite element.
What is the differential answer? Form of equation.
Partial differential.
Differential form of the equation. When you are going to consider the control volume, the resulting governing equations will be of integral type. Instead of control volume, if I am going to consider the fluid element, the resulting type of governing equations will be of differential form. Will be of what? Differential form. Everyone is good. Okay, I can speed up now. Now, what is the difference between the control volume and the fluid element? Now I'm very good, Mr. Kumar. Yeah. Whenever we are going to now move from control volume to this fluid element, what is the difference you find? You have to answer me. Whenever you want to move from control volume to fluid element, what is the difference you found?
Shape.
Finite element has definite shape.
No. This finite element can also change its shape when it's going to move. So don't feel that a finite element means will be looking beautiful. This control volume is not good. It will change its shape. Don't feel like that. Okay. Whatever you told us, right? You are really good. So I want like this only. I don't have to think too much. So Mr. Sukumar P has commented this control volume is imaginary. For Mr. P. Sukumar as well as all the participants, I am telling, even the fluid element is also imaginary. There is no fluid element or no control volume. We are assuming there is a control volume inside the fluid path. Okay. Yeah, very good. I got it from G. Trilog. Okay. I may be wrong in the pronunciation, but he has given me the answer. What the answer he typed means, fluid element will be of smaller size. Control volume will be of bigger size. Okay, Gardalaji, the control volume will be of bigger size and the fluid element will be of smaller size. Comparatively, the size of the fluid element will be smaller when I'm going to consider or compare to that of the control volume. But both are quite enough big to have the fluid particles through them. But both are quite enough to pass the fluid element through them when they are going to be fixed. Okay, so it will not drop the continuum. So that only whenever I am having bigger one and I want to make it a smaller one, I will differentiate. So the resultant form of Gouverneur equations will be of differential form when I am going to consider the fluid element. On the other hand, if the fluid element is going to be grown in shape or grown in size, when it's going to be bigger, it becomes control volume. So the resultant type of Gouverneur equations will be of what? Will be of integral form. So everybody can easily understand, if I'm going to use the control volume, my Gouverneur equations will be of integral form. If I am going to use the fluid element, my Gouverneur equations will be of different form. Whether it's going to be fixed or moving, I'm not worried. Whenever I'm going to use fluid element, the resultant type of Gouverneur equations will be of differential type. Whenever it's going to be of a control volume, the resultant form is called as what? Integral form. Now, then sir, why you draw which is fixed and which is moving? So there should be a difference. Whatever which is fixed is called as conservation form. Whatever which is fixed is called as conservation form. Whatever it is moving is called as non-conservation form. I'll repeat once again. Whether it's going to be fluid element or control volume, if it's going to be fixed, means the resultant type of Gouverneur equations are called as conservation form or conservative type. When the control volume is going to move or the fluid element is going to move, the resultant type of Gouverneur equations are known as what? Non-conservation form. They are for non-conservation. So I can tell FC and MNC. Why I'm telling FC? What does F indicate? What does C indicate?
Fixed control volume.
Fixed?
And conservatives.
Yeah, very good. F stands for fixed, C stands for conservation form. So when you're going to consider the control volume or the fluid element, which is going to fix it, means it is called as conservation form. What is MNC? Yeah, Oscar has given the answer. Yeah. When it's going to be M for what? M for moving. NC for what? Non-conservative.
Non-conservative.
Yeah, non-conservative or non-conservation form. So the left-hand side is a fixed conservative form. The right-hand side is what? Non-conservative form. The left hand side is conservative, the right hand side is non-conservative. Even I can draw the fluid element here. This is the fluid element fixed. Here the fluid element is moving. Okay. So both these things are what? Conservation form. The vertical line is what? Conservative. This vertical line is what? Non-conservative. So it is not depending whether it's a controlling or fluid element. We are not bothered. But if it's going to be fixed, means conservation form. If it's going to be moving, means what? Non-conservation form. Then there should be a difference between top and bottom. Top means integral form. Bottom means differential form. Any doubt? Top means differential form. This above is what? Integral form. Below is what? Differential form. Got the logic? Any doubt? It's very simple. Yeah. Can anyone tell what is this? What will be the type of this equation? The second square. What is the type of equation? The second one. The second one is called as what?
Same integral and differential.
Oh.
Integral.
How can we both integral and differential? Only integral. Okay, only integral. Okay. I'm asking only the second quarter, not the fourth quarter. I'm asking only the second one. Okay, only integral. Then it's not complete. Yeah.
Non-conservative.
Non-conservative.
Yeah, you have to tell me integral non-conservation form. You have to tell us what? Integral non-conservation form. Now can you tell for this one? The third quarter. This one. Third one.
Differential conservative form.
Very good. Differential conservative form. Because it's fixed, but it's a fluid element. So it is a differential and a conservative form. What about the fourth one?
Differential non-conservative form.
Differential non-conservative form. First one?
Integral conservative form.
Differential?
Integral.
Yeah. So integral I hope you are able to understand. Only the problem is me. I'm unable to teach you properly so that you are taking more time. That's it. Okay. So now we know that the different types of governing equations, either it can be integral conservation, integral non-conservation, differential conservation, or differential non-conservation. If I'm going to consider a control volume, then the resultant type of solution should be integral form. If I'm going to consider a fluid element, the resultant type of governing equation will be of differential form. So if I'm going to tell, once again, it'll be boring. So I'll go on to the next equation. Okay. So I will write the equation here. So I hope everyone is able to visualize. So here it will be, it is fixed. So it is dou by dou t of triple integral of rho dv plus double integral of rho v into ds equal to 0. Here it is, I can put a line like this. I will make it as four things. Yeah. Here will be d by dt of triple integral of rho dv equal to 0. The bottom one, here I can tell us dou rho by dou t plus v dot or I can put us del dot rho v equal to 0. Here I can put us d rho by dt plus rho into del dot v equal to 0. All these equations are nothing but represent the same equation, namely called as the continuity equation.
Continuity
equation or what? Conservation of mass.
Conservation of mass.
Here, conservation of mass is known as the principle, and the continuity equation is the corresponding governing equation. I have written four equations. All have the same meaning. Rho 1, A1, V1 equal to what? Rho 2, A2, V2. Otherwise, M dot 1 equal to M dot 2. Got the logic? This is applicable to this also, this also, this also, this also.
Sir, what is the fourth equation you have written on the right bottom side, sir?
Sir, unable to see your writing, sir.
Yeah, fourth equation on the right bottom side, sir. D rho by dou t plus
zero plus rho into del dot v equal to zero. Just a minute. Now it's visible? It's not clear.
No, sir.
Okay, not clear.
Sir.
Zooming
in, there is a problem in Zoom, sir.
Sketch pen, sir. You can use sketch pen or.
This is a problem in Zooming.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
Okay, I'll try. Wait. Now it's clear. I just try to adjust the focal length. Not clear. Tarnima, would help on track.
It might be due to your internet connection, sir. Network issue. Somebody has texted. It may be due to network. Is visible now?
Sir, please tilt the page, sir. It's in a direction to be changed. It's okay. 90 degree.
Now it's fine?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, can you please repeat it, sir?
Sir, you just move towards that particular one. D rho by dt equal to rho dou mu. You just
focus. Was visible to you, Lord? Check net in sort of, but net is clear.
So maybe you can show one equation with the light.
Okay, it's fine. What I can tell me is now it's already 11 o'clock. We'll have a break and I will try to purchase this graphics tablet. If it is fine, means it'll be easy for us to communicate. Otherwise, it'll be very difficult to teach without the board or without the paper. Okay, so let us have a break now. We'll try to meet by 12. Sorry, not 12, 11:30. I will go up to 1 o'clock. If I am not able to give this screen properly to you, then I'll go with the tool in the morning. Between 1 and 3, I try to purchase that graphic tablet, and by 3 to 5, we'll have the theory. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sure.
Okay, sir.
Thanks, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah, please.
Hello, sir. Hello?
Hello? Yes, sir?
Sir, it's here. Okay, sir. We can wind up now, then we can start 11:30, around 11:30 yeah. Again. Okay, sir.
It's fine, sir. Yeah.
Some are blur. Sir, it's now it's okay.
Yeah, fine, sir.
Slightly blurred at the edge only.
Now the screen is visible, sir.
Yeah, screen is visible. Continuity equation.
No, whether the page what I'm writing is visible to my second ID.
The second one, dou rho by dou t plus dou dot rho v vector equal to zero. Now it's blurring, slightly blurring.
It's clear, sir. It's clear, or I have to do some modification?
And the previous So focus.
I could not get you.
So it will automatically focus, I think so, sir. If you are not moving in the sense, it will give some clarity on the particular position.
A bit blur. Okay.
After that, we can move accordingly.
Now it's okay?
No, sir. Same position. I have to just move your cam.
Okay.
Front and back, sir.
Yeah, this is the maximum thing I can get it. Clash,
No, sir. Larry.
Now it's okay. I will try with another network. Yeah, network bandwidth is slow. Network the problem. Phone to the table, I'm up somewhere to drop. That's better. The Mola camera is the camera chipper. The 85 zoom upper color. The number is in my company, right? Coming? Oh?
The screen is coming, sir.
Whether it's visible now? The screen is coming. Whether it's clear?
Yeah.
Talk, sir. That's fine.
Sir, network problem only. Screen. Screen.
No, echo can be overcome. Echo can be overcome.
No, sir. Screen network bandwidth is low.
Okay, is that internet is low? Okay. Let me come here. That's because of the network band. Okay, sir. Otherwise, we will move the tool. After that, I will make ready everything. And now we can move the tool, I hope.
Okay.
Because let us not waste the time. They are close. Close it. Bandwidth in the lower, so they will not be able to visualize properly. So everyone, can you go with the tools? Hello.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, whether I'm audible?
Yes, audible.
Okay, fine. This is because of some practical difficulties we are unable to do it. Anyhow, I'll try in the afternoon. Okay. And the bandwidth also a problem. Interconnectivity is also a problem. Okay. Anyhow, we'll manage now. I will try to open the tool, then I'll come back to you. Yeah.
We can start, sir.
Yeah, about to start. The application is getting open. After that, we can start. Yeah. If everyone is able to see the screen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we shall move the tool now. Meantime, I will try to purchase the kit so that we can have the theory portion in the afternoon. Everyone can put your thing in mute mode. Okay, please. Put your phones in mute mode so that we can rush up some more topics for the next 1 hour, 1.5 hours if possible. Yeah, first you go to file, change working directory, and fix the directory where you want to work. So yesterday I created the E drive. So I'll go to the E drive. Then in the E drive also, I'll go with GCT. GCT also I have mesh. So this is the folder I created.
Hello, can I say hello?
Sorry, ma'am. On the phone, put it. Start out. Yes. Okay. What is the working directory? Is set.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay. So we just follow the instructions. I can do. Okay.
Please, everyone, please put your... That's nice. Yes, whether you are able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, fine. Yeah, so we can see here, I have went to E folder and I changed the working directory to GCT bar mesh. Now let us try to open the geometry which is available there. So geometry, open geometry, because yesterday we created the geometries. So I'm going to take the geometry from yesterday case. Only cylinder is there. Before the cylinder, I will try to go with the cube. I will create a cube now itself. So I can get the cube from the geometry. Then I can go here. And if you want, I can go to the standard shapes. Okay, then the dimensions are 1, 1, 1. So instead of 1, 1, 1, we can give us what? 50, 50, 50. And give apply. Yeah, so now we can get this one. Yeah, we can see here a cube is being formed. So let's, there are some disturbances. Okay. Yeah, fine. So this is the cube. We have 450 mm by 50 mm by 50 mm. And yesterday, as I told you, this has only, you can see, points. There are not even points are there. If you want to see the points, you can see the points. Points, curves, and the surface. Whatever you don't want to use this, you can toggle it. So curves also you can toggle it. Like this, it can be there. Now, this one, first of all, we'll name it fastly because we know yesterday still how to name the geometry. So here I'm going to make it fast. Parts, right click, create part. There I'm going to give the names, inlet. So this one I'm going to choose as inlet. And I'll change the color if you want. Yeah, then I'll go to the other side. And I'll name it to the outlet. So don't worry to work with your mouse. The mouse has only 3 buttons. Okay, one is the left button, another is the, if you are going to have the left button hold, and if I'm going to drag it, I can rotate it. So left mouse button, you just press it and hold it, then rotate like this. It'll automatically rotate. And the middle button, you do like this. You scroll it. It'll be either zoomed up or zoomed out. Okay, according to the need. And the right button, you click, nothing is happening now. After that, we'll see what is the right button. So now I will see only the left button and the middle button. Okay, once again, I can, if I'm going to hold the right button and I'm going to, I can also move like this. Fine. And then create part, top. So this is the top wall or top and right. I'm simply naming. So right. So this is the one. And if I want to rotate, I can rotate the back. So I want to see that bottom. And this is the left. Left. Okay, so we have named your surfaces, and if you want, I can give the bottom also the color to be blue. This color can be given to the bottom because it's not available. Yeah, fine. So we have given the various names as well as the various surfaces, and if I'm going to remove the surface, you will get like this. Yesterday, what we have discussed is that yesterday we have discussed for a tetrahedral mesh. Today we are going to see the superior type of mesh, especially the hexahedral type of meshing. So for the hexahedral type of meshing, a new concept known as blocking should be implemented. A new concept known as blocking. Yesterday what we did for tetrahedral mesh is that I created a body. I went here. Then I told fluid air. I given any name. It can be fluid water also you can give today. No problem. Then what I did yesterday means I have marked the point like this, this point and this point, and we created a body, a fluid body was created. And I asked you to verify whether it is inside the domain, because the domain should not be the body should not be away from the domain, it should be inside the domain. So these are the things we did yesterday for a tetrahedral type of mesh. But for hexahedral type of mesh, this body is not required. We can do this body. There's no need to create the body. There's no need to create the body. Please, everyone, please listen. For tetrahedral mesh only, we need to create a body. In case of hexahedral mesh, there's no need of creating the body. Now, for hexahedral mesh, you should not go to mesh. You have to go to for blocking. You have to go for what? Blocking. This is very, very important concept. Blocking is a very, very important concept. Then you can see here, there are number of icons. But you can see, there's only one icon which can create the block. Others are inactive. So the only opportunity is that you can click only this button. Okay, so it is this button is click on. And here you can see create block, a name solid is there. So don't put solid, you put as fluid. If you want, what are the name you given there? So it is fluid air. Okay, sir? So hello.
Sir, can
hello, yeah. Sir, you can give permission to the participants, no problem. But to the participants, please kindly cooperate that you don't get a background noise or other noise which will disturbance the class. Please. Sir, you can give permission to all.
They can use.
Yeah. Please, all
sir,
of you.
Can you please repeat it again, sir? Body.
No, I couldn't get you.
Can you please repeat it again, sir? Block option. For what we have to use, for what purpose you have to use.
At the end, I will explain you for what we are going to do and all, I will explain at the end. Okay. So, until the end, if you are asking any doubt what I am teaching, if you are not able to understand, you please tell me, I will explain you. But anything new, you please ask at the end. Okay. For example, when I am creating a part, if you are unable to know how to make it, sir, can you please explain, means I will explain you. If you want to know why it's like that means I can explain you at the end of the class. At the end of the class means after blocking is over, I'll tell you. Okay, I'm sorry for that. Let us go to certain extent. Then we can ask doubt. Please ask doubt in what I'm explaining. Okay, if you are unable to catch me, what I am telling or speaking, you please stop me and ask me a question. I'm ready to answer you. But if anything new is there, I will try to answer you at the end of the session. After the blocking or something like that. So now we are going for create blocking. This blocking is used to create the hexahedral mesh. So that only we are going for blocking. That may be the answer for the question you asked. So now we can see here create block. And here it was solid. I given the fluid air. Now where I have to form the block? Then you choose this icon. Select geometry. Which geometry you want? I want for the entire geometry. I want the block for the entire geometry. So choose. Either you can choose like this, or you can choose from this one also. Select all appropriate visible object. Both are fine. So I given this one. So now we can see a tree have been formed in the left hand side as blocking. Earlier there was no blocking. Now I have created a tree with a blocking branch. Okay. Now if I opening the blocking branch, I can see there's a edges which is highlighted. So we want to see the edges, what you do means you toggle points, curves, surfaces, bodies. Now we can see these are nothing but the edges. If I'm going to remove this also, you can see the edges will be going away. So this is nothing but an edge. Now what we have to do means in blocking, we have to associate the edge to the curve. The curve is available in the geometry. You can see the curve is available under the geometry. The edge is available under the blocking. Now we have to associate each and every edge to its corresponding curve in the geometry. I will repeat once again. Curves are available in the geometry. Edges are available under blocking. Now we have to associate. What is meant by associate means you have to associate the edge to its corresponding curve. Sir, how to do that? You listen here. Before I am going to associate, you can see what are the color of the edges. All are black in color. After association, this black color will change its color. Let us see now. So now what I am going to do means after creating the block, now you can see all these icons have been highlighted. They become active. Earlier they are not active. Now all the icons become what? Active. Now go to the fifth icon, associate icon, and press it. When you are going to press it, the first one you keep, what is showing? Associate a vertex. But we are not going to associate a vertex. I am going to second one. Second one is what? Associate the edge to the curve. Yeah, this one I want. So go to this one and press it with the left mouse button. Now choose this edge. Which edge I am choosing? This edge I am choosing. Then which curve I have to choose? The same curve I just choose. So now we can see. No, it is not selected. Okay, so I will do it once again. So choose this edge. Choose this edge and the corresponding curve. Yeah, it's selected. And give apply. Apply means center button. So we can see here, this edge becomes in what color now? Green color. A green color edge shows that this edge has been associated to a curve. I will repeat once again. We have to associate the edges in the blocking to the corresponding curve in the geometry. So we have to associate the edge to the curve. How it can be done? We can, earlier we are here. Now we have to move the cursor from the first icon to the fifth icon. That icon is nothing but associate icon. After going here, initially it will be like this only. But you should not be here. You have to move to the second icon. That is associate the edge to the curve. So when you're going to take this curve, then what I have to do means, you already have done this one. So I will take the other curves and do it. You associate this curve to this edge or edge to the curve. Now we can see, yeah, that edge also become green in color. So I hope I can move fast. So this edge with this curve, this edge with this curve. Now we can see all these four edges will be turned green in color, which means they have been associated to the corresponding curves. Then this edge to this one, I am making it fast because I hope you understand it. It may be boring you also, so I make it fast. I am doing it for all the edges. If there's any doubt, you can ask me through chat and I'll be able to rectify also if you have any specific doubts. Now we can see, I have associated all the what? I have associated all the edges to the curves. Okay, yeah. Mr. Oscar, you asked out in the geometry what I'm teaching you. It may be simple, but we have participants from every place. They may not be knowing the simple geometry also. So simply we'll start from a simple geometry. Then we'll finally go to a very complex geometry where you will be interested. Now it may be boring for you. I accept it. But slowly we'll go step by step. Okay. It will be useful to all the participants in the group. Thank you. Thank you for your cooperation. Yeah.
Sir,
now, yeah.
Sir, is there any possible way to select all the edges at once?
No, it's not possible. It's not possible. It's a very good question. Whether it's possible to choose all the edges to a curve means it is possible when the curves are going to be the same curve. But now the curves are different, so it's not possible. For example, if I'm having some 8 edges, all these 8 edges are going to be connected to a single curve means I can choose all the 8 edges and connect to a single curve. I will do that in future. But when you have a single edge to a single curve, there's no other way. We have to do individually. We have to do what? Individually. I understood. It may be some time consuming problem, but there's no other way. We have to do that. Good. Good. Good question. Yeah. Fine. Now, after this one, sometime there's a possibility I may associate this edge to this, instead of this curve, I may associate wrongly to the other curves, isn't it? There's a possibility I may do some mistakes. So, for example, for this curve, I am going to associate to this, I have associated this edge to this curve, whether it's right or wrong. It is wrong. Fine. So you are able to get it. Just I want to know whether we are able to follow. So, but it should be associated only to this one. Then how to know? Now also you can see the edges will be only in green color. But how to know whether it's right or wrong? For that, right click on edges and show association. Now we can see this edge is associated to this particular curve, which is wrong. Which is what? Wrong. So I have done some mistake. So like this, we can check whether we have associated it properly or not. Okay, fine. So how to rectify once again? Go to edges and go to curve. Now once again it went away. Even though we have show association, it is not showing anything wrong. So which means we have associated it properly. So if there's any doubt how to create a block and how to associate the edge to the curve and to check whether we have associated them rightly or wrongly. Whether all are clear up to here? I hope you are clear. Okay. Since there is no question, I take it as for granted. You are clear with the concept. Then, what I am going to do means I am going to go for this pre-mesh info. Okay, fine. Then we can go to the pre-mesh option. Then you can choose this one and choose this particular. I will repeat once again. Now I am going to, from first icon, I went to fifth icon. Now sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. I am going for the ninth icon, which is nothing but the pre-mesh parameters. They are given as params, which is related to parameters. So pre-mesh parameters, go to this icon, click on this one. Then you choose the edge. So which is the edge? This is the edge. And what is the length of the edge? It is 50. 50 means generally is 50 mm. So the length of this edge is what? 50 mm. So how many nodes are there now? Only two nodes. The first node is here, the next node is here. But what I'm going to do is, now I am going to put 100 nodes. I'm going to put how many nodes? 100 nodes. How to see that? I'm zooming it. You can see here. Can you able to visualize? There will be some 100 nodes along this edge. Along this edge, we are having 100 nodes. As earlier, some person asked me, sir, whether it's not possible to associate all the edge to a curve. Here, I can associate the, now only one edge is given the value. But I want to give the value to all the edges. It is possible. How it is possible means, you go to copy parameters. I'm going to copy the same value to all other edges, which are going to be parallel. Which are going to be what? Parallel. Now this edge, and this edge are parallel to this edge. So I want to copy the same value of 100 from this edge to all other parallel edges. To all other parallel edges. So if I'm going to remove this one, I will not have. If I'm going to give this one tick on, it will have. Got it? So either you can give individually or combinedly also, but you can give combinedly onto the parallel edges. Then give apply. Okay. Similarly, now I am going to choose this edge. Now it will take care of all the horizontal edges, isn't it? Yeah. Now it will be, instead of 50, I am going to give 100. And give apply. Then go to here. Here also give 100. And give copy parameters. Now apply. Now we can see, if you want to see the pre-mesh, how it looks like. So this is the pre-mesh. Okay. And how does the pre-mesh look like? You can see. Can you see the mesh, how it looks like? Yesterday, what are the mesh you saw is called as tetrahedral mesh. What are the mesh now you are seeing is called as hexahedral mesh. So I hope I explained the concept of hexahedral mesh and the tetrahedral mesh very easily. Okay, whatever we seen yesterday is tetrahedral. Now whatever we are seeing now is called as hexahedral mesh. This mesh can be generated only by blocking methodology. It can be generated by what? The other methodology, namely yesterday what we done is what? Tetrahedral. What we have done now is nothing but hexahedral. And there are some doubts. Let us see. Yeah. Okay. So it's normal. Okay, fine. So we can see we are able to create the block. And with the help of block, we are able to generate the hexagonal mesh. Yesterday, some of our participants asked, sir, how to check the quality of these mesh elements? I told for tetrahedral elements, nothing to worry. Only the problem is with the quality. If the quality is going to be positive, it's almost done. So don't worry about the quality for the tetrahedral mesh. Automatically, it will be good. But in case of hexahedral mesh, actually, the quality, we had to check minimum two parameters. The two parameters are minimum angle and determinant. Minimum angle and what? Determinant. So how to check the quality? This is the quality. Pre-mesh quality histograms. You click on this button to check whether, now when you are seeing the mesh is very good. Why? Because looking very nicely is amazing. There's no problem. But that alone doesn't reflect that the mesh is good. So in order to ensure the quality of the mesh, you please click on the icon, namely the Q button. And since it's a three-dimensional geometry, you go to the determinant 3 by 3 by 3, not 2 by 2 by 2. You go to what? 3 by 3 by 3 and give apply. Now a histogram will be formed. You can see the histogram value is showing minimum also 1, maximum also 1. That means it's a very, very perfect mesh. No other mesh can be more better than this one, because the minimum value of the determinant itself is what? 1 only. But for most complicated geometries, it should not be even less than 0.3. It is as per the industry standards. It's a general thumb rule. Whenever we are doing a mesh, even for a complicated mesh, complicated geometry, and you are trying to do with the hexagonal mesh, the industry will ask for a minimum determinant of 0.3 for the minimum element. But for all the elements, here we have a determinant value of 1. You can see here, I hope everyone can see this transcript window, where the minimum determinant value is also 1 and the maximum determinant value is also 1. Very nice. Okay, I want to check the quality also. This is also one of the quality. The other quality what I want you to check is the angle. The first one is the angle. So you press it here. I'm checking for the angle. So here also there's a beauty, because the minimum angle is also 90, maximum angle is also 90. That is, all the elements have 90 degrees. All are perfectly at right angles to each other. So the mesh is also paka. For a complicated geometry in industry, if you are going for the hexagonal mesh, then the minimum angle required is 80. You should not drop below 80 degree. You should go above 18 degree. You should come below what? 18 degree. If you are even 18 degree is fine. 90 degree is also fine. But there should not be even a single element with a minimum angle less than 18 degree. Say, for example, I have a minimum angle of some 5 elements having 11 degree. Then the industry will not accept it. No, you have to refine the mesh. Increase the angle by 18 degree, like that detour. But as one of the participants told, this geometry is very, very simple and is nothing is there. Since I have taken this geometry to explain you more clearly the concepts of blocking and the concept of association, I have taken simple geometry and hence my angle is also good. My determinant is also wonderful. Both are really amazing. Now, what are the mesh I have seen is not the, here you can see a number of parameters are there. You can say aspect ratio, constant radius, distortion, then what, external face aspect ratio. There are many things. There may be number of quality check parameters, but the minimum two things required in the industry are the angle and the determinant. The angle should be more than 18 degree for a complex geometry. The determinant should be more than 0.3 for a complex geometry. For a simple geometry like this cube, it is obvious that if you are not getting 90 degree and determinant 1 only, it is bad. It is obvious you can get a very good angle and determinant. So far what you have seen is not the mesh, it's only the pre-mesh. I will repeat the point. So far, whatever we are seeing in the screen is not the mesh, it's only the pre-mesh. You can also see it's a pre-mesh. Now, if I want to see, go to the mesh, please right-click on the pre-mesh. Please right-click on the pre-mesh. Then you put as convert to unstructured mesh. Okay, so far there's a no, you can see here, there's no tree called a branch of tree called as mesh. But once I click this button, it will convert into the unstructured mesh. So convert to unstructured mesh. I press the icon. Now you can see a new branch emerges here and is named as mesh. And is named as what? Mesh. Okay, you expand the tree, mesh. You can see cells and volumes like yesterday. Like what we have created, cells and volumes in tetrahedral. Here also you can cells and volumes in this one. Here also there is no need of pre-mesh. Here also there is no need of pre-mesh, because already we have the original mesh itself. Now this mesh is original mesh. It's not a pre-mesh. Now, even though the angle and determinant have satisfied the minimum requirement what is meant for, but still we can't tell the mesh is free of error. But still we can't tell the mesh is free of error. The quality is good. The determinant is good. But still there may be possibility the mesh may have some errors. So once again, we have to repeat the same step what we have done yesterday for the tetrahedral mesh. So what we did yesterday, go to edit mesh and click this icon, check mesh. And yesterday also I told, don't change these values, leave the default values. Give simply apply. Give simply apply. So it has taken some more time because the number of mesh calls will be more. I will repeat once again. Otherwise, we can see here there's no, you can move up and you can see there are no red color marks, which means there's no problem with the mesh. That is, the mesh is free of duplicate elements, it's free of uncovered faces, it's free of volume rotation problem like that. So all the problems are not there. You can see that all these problems are not there. So it's really a good mesh. Then, once again, what I'm going to do is when this is okay, you go to file, save project, because now there's a file called as blocking file. The file name can be saved as file blocking, save blocking as. I can save the blocking alone as cube. I can save it what? Cube.block. The extension will be d.blk. Yesterday itself I told in the PowerPoint, .blk is the extension for our block files. Okay. Now I can save the entire project. File, save project as. Project means you will take care of what? A tin file, block file, dot UNS file, dot ADR file, dot FBC file. All these files will take care. So I'll give the same name, cube. Okay. So everyone is able to appreciate the work. So we can see the mesh is formed. If you want to check whether the mesh is inside or not, as yesterday I told you, you create a plane, cut plane, mesh, cut plane, flow cut plane, or give apply. Otherwise, you go to mesh, cut plane, manage cut plane. Okay, you give one, here also you give zero, then you give apply. Okay, still we have not given the shells. Yeah. Now we can see, we have put on the shells. We can see the cut plane. Yesterday we have seen the cut plane is what? Somewhat up and down, but here it's external, it'll be uniform. And you put the volume mesh also. So we can see there's a 3D mesh available. You can see how much fantastic it is today compared to the mesh yesterday. Yesterday the mesh was not this much good. It is tetrahedral, but today we are having a hexagonal mesh. If you want to see in the other direction also, you can see it, zero, and change the direction. So we can see a vertical mesh. And if you want to move also, you can move it. You can see, I can drag it, and we can visualize at a particular location, how it is like that. Got it, what I'm telling you. So if you're going to vary the fraction value, I can move the cut plane, and I can visualize it. I hope there's a volume mesh also. It's not a 2D mesh, it's a 3D mesh. It's a 3D mesh. So once we are happy with all these things, then I can remove the volumes. I can, there's no need to show the cut plane. Okay. And finally, I can save the project file, save project. And if you want to see cells, you can see. Cells means only the outer wall, surface mesh. But there's a volume mesh also is there. Now, as usual, yesterday, like yesterday, we can go to output mesh, go to this icon, go to Ansys CFX and give apply. And go to this last one, save current project first. Yeah. Now the file name will be, you can see the file name, cube.cfx5. .cfx5 is the file which is importable in the Ansys CFX preprocessor. Done. Sir, I don't want to work in Ansys CFX. I want to work in only Ansys Fluent. Then how to do it, sir? I will tell you. Go to this first icon. It's still saving. So you can see here, output. If you want to see what is the number of mesh count, info, mesh info. Now if you want to see what is the mesh count, you can see it is nearly 10 lakhs 30,293 elements are there. How many elements are there? 10,30,293 elements are there. How many nodes are there? 10 lakh nodes are there. With the 10 lakh nodes, it is able to form 10,30,000 elements, hexadecimal elements. So we can see one particular domain is divided into 10 lakh small elements. This process is called as discretization or meshing. It's called as what? Discretization or meshing. Okay, I hope you know what is meant by meshing now. Breaking a single domain into a number of small domains of infinite capacities. Here the infinite capacity is only 10 lakh and 30,000 elements are there. So if you want to take this one to the fluent and import, go to instead of CFX, you take it fluent, you apply, then click the fourth icon, say let it be say the project, nothing wrong. If also not required, you can give no also. Because the project is already saved, there's no need to save it. Give open. Now in fluent only, you have to give the name. So you remove the fluent and type cube underscore fluent. Fluent is not required. For our understanding, I'm giving fluent. Otherwise, you can leave fluent new, something. Nothing wrong in that. So you can give that. So fluent is not a keyword. There's no need to give fluent. It's not necessary. Okay. Since in order to understand, I've given as a fluent.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yeah, now last one minute. Actually, this one, the file name will end up with the .msh. .msh extension file is file which is openable in ANSYS Fluent. Yeah, now the session is open for your questions. Yeah.
Sir, I need to know how to decide upon what should be the mesh size while meshing any minimum mesh size which can give the answers accurately.
Yeah, really is a good question. And it will be useful to all the participants. The general thumb rule is 1:1. What is 1:1 means? For 1 mm, one element is required. For 1 mm, one element is required. Which means, here you can see in the pre-mesh, I have given for this pre-mesh, blocking pre-mesh, I have given, what is the length of this edge? What is the length of this edge?
50,
sir.
But how much we have given?
100. So it is 100. Twice.
Twice the accuracy. Generally, we have given here better mesh size. 50, out of 50, 50 is sufficient. But in order to ensure better quality, for every mm, for every 0.5 mm, I have given one mesh element.
So if that is the case,
this is the I know your question, and this is the general answer. But beyond to this one, in order to capture the boundary layer and all, it should be very very fine in order to capture your y plus value. Okay.
Okay.
Now whatever I told is only the very very basic. Let us go step in step. Let me get to your question also. Yeah, you post your question. Madam, you can post your question, yeah. You can tell your question.
Yes, sir. So if that is the case, so will the analysis results be same beyond the minimum required mesh, or it will even after that also it will change? That means if we have initially, if we have 50, if we have 75, if we have 100, if we go beyond that also, will the analysis results change or not, sir?
Yeah. What you are talking is called as grid independent study. Whatever you are speaking now is known as grid independent study. I'm going to explain to all the participants. It's not difficult. All of you can listen here. Madam is asking, instead of for 50 length of the edge, we have tried with the 100. So instead of, I can also try with the 200. Please, others can put your phone in mute mode, please. The length we can give 200, still 300. Then which is best? The answer is infinite is best. But infinite is possible in nature? No, it is not possible. So, for example, in this flow analysis, if you want to measure the temperature at exit, let us assume a flow problem is there where I want to measure the temperature at a outlet of the flow. When I'm going to put 1 lakh, let us assume that when I'm going to put 100 as my length of the elements in this particular edge, I'm getting the temperature to be 323. For example, I'm telling. Then I'm going to increase the number of nodes from 100 to 200. Now instead of 323, I'm getting a value say 326, which means now the mesh number of nodes have an impact on the outcome. Still, the results are sensitive to your mesh count. Then what I'm going to do means instead of 200 elements, I'm going to put 300. Now instead of 326, I'm going to get a value of 327. Earlier when I put 100 number of elements on a particular edge of 50 mm length, I got a temperature value of 323. That's fine. But I'm not happy with the 100 elements. I'm trying with the 200 number of nodes or 200 number of elements. Then I am finding the answer. The temperature has risen from 323 to 326. Then also I am not happy. Still I am going to raise the number of nodes in the particular edge from 200 to 300. Now also there is a variation which is going to be 327. Now I am still going to increase the number of nodes to 400. Instead of 300, I am going to put as 400. Now also the temperature instead of 327, it is 327.0005. Now I am telling, when I'm going to raise the value from 300 to 400, now my temperature is varying from 327 to what? 327.0005, which means practically there's no change in the temperature. So there is no need to go for 400 number of nodes. It's enough to go for a simulation with the 300 number of nodes itself for all other cases, whatever you are going to carry out in future hereafter. I'll repeat once again. Whenever you are outcome is not going to vary with the number of elements you are given, so there is no need to further increase the number of nodes. This is called as greedy independent study. Okay, so there's no difference between 300 number of nodes and 400 number of nodes. Both are giving the same answer, almost same answer, 99.9% same answer. Then you can proceed all over further summation with the 300 number of nodes for the all the edges. I hope I have clarified your doubt. As well as I have introduced to the team what is meant by grid independent study. That is, the solution what you have obtained now is independent of the grid beyond 300 elements in a particular edge. Got it?
So in that case, so we need to start with mesh of 1 mm size and then go ahead increasing the size until we reach the grid independent thing.
Yeah.
So is it that same thing should be done even for complex geometries? It becomes very tough to even mesh once also for if geometry is very complex. That case also we need to do so many trials, sir. Or is there any other option for, because meshing
I can get your point. Even though for complex geometry like a gas turbine combustor, even though it will take some 7 hours, 8 hours to mesh also, there's no other way. At least you have to try with at least three type of mesh counts. Minimum three types of mesh counts is necessary.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So we can't compromise on anything, because for gas turbine combustor and all, there's no other way to validate. At least we have to do the grid independent study. There's no other way.
Okay, sir.
For solving also, it may take some 10 days or 15 days, but there's no other way.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Others, please, if you have any questions in what we have dealt now, for the simple geometry also, I'm ready to answer you. If you have other questions related to this meshing also, you can ask, no problem. And now you know what is the importance of blocking. Without blocking, I cannot go for the hexagonal mesh.
Sir?
Yeah?
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible, professor. Yeah.
Sir, what's the difference between a structured mesh and unstructured mesh? Why we have converted into unstructured mesh?
The way we are converted to unstructured mesh is that it will be easy for the system to do the calculation. That is the only difference. But when you are going to write your own coding and all, we'll go with structured mesh. Structured mesh is nothing but I can give the, for example, there are 5 houses in a row. If I can tell the third house, if you are staying in the third house and I'm staying in the first house, I can tell this person is after two houses is my friend, he's taking the third house. Like that, I can interrelate one mesh element with another mesh element. It's called a structure. in all the axes, x axis, y axis, and z axis. That is called a structured mesh. Whereas unstructured mesh, we can't give like that. We can't relate one mesh element with another mesh element. Okay, that will mostly happen in the tetrahedral mesh. And in case of hexahedral mesh also, we are making like that because it will be easy for the solver to solve when it's going to take in the solver point of view. It is not for the meshing point of view, but it will be easy for the solver to analyze it easily. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sir, last question, sir. One more question. Sir, which one will give better results, sir, whether tet mesh or hex mesh, sir?
Surely it is hexahedral mesh. There's no doubt. It is surely hexahedral mesh. Will give better results than the tetrahedral mesh, as well as it will take less time to compute. And the stability criteria also will be very good if you're going with the hexahedral mesh. Tetrahedral mesh will not be having that much stability. Convergence criteria also will be written fast with the hexahedral mesh. But you may ask a question, then why you want to go for tetrahedral meshing? Because there are certain geometries where hexahedral mesh is not at all possible.
Circular for, kind of.
Yeah. Even for a gas turbine compressor, you can't go with fully hexahedral mesh. There may be hybrid mesh, but you can't go with what? Fully hexahedral. It's not at all possible. And hence, we are going for tetrahedral. Yeah.
Sir, for cylindrical pipes, can we go with hexamesh?
Yeah, the next question I'm going to do is that the cylindrical mesh only now. Let us, shall we move to the cylindrical mesh? If anyone others have some doubts related to what we discussed, I'm ready to explain, or else we can go to the cylindrical mesh.
Sir, how mesh quality is exactly affecting the results, simulation results? Like angles you mentioned earlier.
Actually, it's a complex phenomenon. Just like our body biology, and the same person, if you're going to the state, some person is getting affected with corona, some people are not getting affected with corona, even though they're less lethargic also, okay, and some people will affect with, they will tell my body is a hot body. Similarly, in CFD also, we can see, it's a multi-complex phenomenon. And one of the aspects what we are looking is, please take care of the angle and determinant. Because this angle and determine these quality aspects will lead you to instability problem, will lead you to divergence problem, will lead to you to the inaccurate results. These things will come to know not immediately, but in future classes. It can't be addressed immediately. It can be taken in only due classes. I'm going to teach the theoretical part where I'll come up with the discretization error, round off error, truncated error, and a double question, single question. All these things will be explained there. Then you will come to know, okay, this much of complexity is there. So, but generally what the doctor used to say, if you are going to the doctor, they used to tell, reduce your body weight. Keep a low level of taking food and maintain the body mass index. But there is also a problem in the body mass index also good. A person may undergo some problem, isn't it? So we can't directly relate, but most of the cases will be like that. Similarly, here also, most of the cases in the angle and determinant are able to maintain above a particular value. The sources somewhat quite stable. Based on the experience only, we are telling these values. Okay, yeah. This will come with the experience only. It will take a lot of time.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, am I audible to you, sir?
Yeah, you are audible, but somewhat shaky. Yeah.
So, yes, you have discussed about structured mesh and unstructured mesh, sir. Is there any mesh specific to the application for this application? These are all the mesh types we have to use. Is there anything like that, sir?
No. From actually, the meshing itself, you want to understand very clearly, it will take some 6 months of time to understand the concepts very clearly. Okay. In ICCFD tool, whatever we are going to export is mostly the unstructured mesh. Here, the unstructured mesh, because even though we are creating hexahedral mesh, we are connecting into unstructured mesh in order to have for easy calculation purpose. Okay, but when you are going to write your own code only, you can enjoy the freedom of unstructured mesh. So my idea is that if you can write simple 2D codes and you can check the difference between the unstructured mesh and the structured mesh, you feel very easy when you are going to write a structured mesh, but not with the software. Okay, every software will have some own pros and cons that will reflect on the outcome. Definitely, surely. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, fine. Shall we move to the next geometry? If you are okay with this one, shall we move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So for blade design pumps, etc., we could use hexa. Yeah, we can use a hexa for plane design I have done. It will be quite complicated, but it's possible to do hexagonal mesh for the blade design, even for centrifugal pumps and blowers, it's possible. What is Y plus value? Yeah. And how we can find out? Yeah, I'm going to explain after this class, after this cylinder tutorial. Two different mesh types when used at same time is called a hybrid mesh. Yes, you are right. If I'm going to use both hexagonal and tetrahedral, that type of mesh is called as a hybrid mesh. Okay. For pipe design, which mesh is possible? We can go with the water, hexagonal mesh itself. That's what we are going to do now. Okay. So don't worry. Your questions through chat also, I'm trying to address you. Okay, fine. Let us now go. Pipe and cylinder are both the same. Pipe and cylinder are both the same. Even I have done a helical heat pipe with my M.Tech students, and we have done the heat transfer list fully with the hexagonal mesh, not with the tetrahedral mesh, fully with the hexagonal mesh. Let us move forward because we have only half an hour time left. We'll make it fast. Okay, I'll move to the next one. File, yeah, already we have saved it. And hence I will close the project. No need to save once again. Yeah, fine. File, once again, I go for geometry. You see how I'm opening geometry. Already geometry I created yesterday. So there's no need to create a geometry. Go to geometry, open geometry. Okay, so you go to open geometry, then give cylinder. Give open. Because yesterday itself I told how to create a cylinder, so I am not creating the cylinder now. Isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, kinetic cylinder also we can go with the hexagonal mesh. I got done with the hexagonal mesh. Okay. Crash analysis, that is not dealing with CFD, that deals with the structural analysis. You should have to ask the question to a expert from the field. I am not good in that crash analysis. Okay, fine. Now let us please come back to this portion. After this, we'll have the question and answer session. Now, please, no more questions now. You please listen to me. Thanks for your understanding. Now, once again, it's a tetrahedral mesh. Yesterday, we put a mesh. You can see file mesh, open mesh. And I'm going to put a cylinder here. Yesterday, you can see how does a tetrahedral mesh looks like, isn't it? Yesterday we have done this mesh. I hope you can recall. Today I don't want this mesh. File, mesh, close mesh. I don't want hexagonal mesh. Tetrahedral mesh. But I want hexagonal mesh. So which is not required now? This fluid air body is not required. Okay, fine. Yeah. Please provide me with the screen share. Yeah, share. If everyone is able to see the screen.
Yes, sir.
Now let us delete this fluid air, which is not required for the tetrahedral type of mesh. So, geometry, delete body, and I'm going to delete this body. Okay. This body is taken care by the name of the block name, what you are providing in hexagonal mesh. So, once again, I'll repeat you. The body, what you are creating in tetrahedral mesh, is replaced by the name of the blocking, what you are assigning for creating a block. I hope I made it clear. So there's no need to define a body. If I create a block itself, that name will be taken as the body name. Okay, indirectly. So now we can see there's a point as the surface is there. Now let us move to the hexagonal type of meshing. Go to blocking. Because I don't want a tetra, so I'm jumping from geometry to blocking. Which icon will be highlighted? Only the first icon will be highlighted. All other icons will be like this. We can't utilize them. So you first click the first button. Then here you put as fluid air. I can even call it as what? Fluid cylinder air. Please, my recommendation is always when you're creating a body or the name of a block, you please specify either it's a fluid or a solid. Nowhere it's going to be solid. Mostly it'll be only fluid. But you please give the name appropriately. So like fluid underscore cylinder underscore air, which means air is the working medium, which is fluid, which is going through along a cylinder. Like that, it will be easy for you to understand. So once it's done, what I had to choose? I had to choose this entire geometry, all visible objects. Otherwise, I can even put like this, from here to here, drag. But now I'm going to choose this icon. Yeah. Now we can see I have created the block for this one. Yeah. Then, yes. Why this error and all is coming means, don't worry. Here the option is that this is under source session. If I'm going to remove this one, that error heads will not come. So don't get worried. Sir, how it is, why it's showing like that and all. So I don't want to show those. And yeah, I can show, I'm just as sharing my screen alone. Now how to associate? Because there's a surface, there's also some edges. I do not know how to associate. Here also, we have to associate the edges to the curves. So go to the association and go to the, don't go to the first one, you go to the second one. Which one? Which is nothing but what? Edges to the curve. Now only you can do like this. You can see here, I'm not going to choose one edge. I'm going to choose four edges. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here what I did, I did only one edge to a one curve. But here I am choosing all the four edges because all these four edges should be associated to this curve. So that only I have done like this. Are you okay? So once again, repeat you. Now there are four edges corresponding to one curve. So you have to choose all the four edges to that particular curve. Then your problem is solved. Similarly, at the back surface also, you choose all the four edges. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you associate to this particular curve. You will get the solution. Okay. Now this is associated. But you may have a doubt. Sir, these edges, these vertex, they are not on the surface. They are away. Okay. These vertex, they are not on the surface of the curve, but they are away from this one. So how to put it inside or how to pull them inside? That may be your question. Yeah. For that, you can use this particular icon. What is this particular icon? Snap, project vertices. You project the vertices to the particular geometry. So you click this button and give apply. You can see now the vertex which were outside of this particular cylinder domain have been brought to the curves to which they have been associated. I hope I made it clear. If you want, I may repeat you once again. I have used undo operation, but mostly I will recommend not to use the undo operation in ICCFD. Why? Because means sometimes because of a debug problem, some bug problem, it will just get escape from the screen itself. Your ICCFD will be closed without any warning. So please try to avoid undo operation at the maximum possible. Okay, if you want to do undo operation also, save that before, then you give the undo operation. Now what I'm telling is now these four vectors, but I want to project it to the curve. For that, what I'm going to use, here I was here, but you move down diagonally downwards. This is nothing but what? Snap project vectors. Click this button. Then also it will not move. Then you apply. Definitely it will move. So I hope everyone got the logic how we can project the vertices. Okay. Any doubt up to here? If there's any doubt, I'll stop and answer you. Otherwise, I'll proceed further. Okay, fine. Now I will go with I hope there's no doubts. Everybody is able to understand. Yeah. Yes, this software is only meant for machine only. Yeah. Why there's a doubt now? I told from yesterday. Yeah, fine. Now we'll go to pre-mesh parameters. So now we can see this edge. This edge is 51 number of nodes. Nothing wrong. If you want, you can do 80 also. I'm giving twice generally. So 80. And given parallel edges also. If you're not given this parallel edges, it will be only for this edge. If I'm going to give parallel edges, then it will be copied for all the parallel edges. Then what about this length? This length is what, 100 mm length. So if you want, I can give 200 mm. 200 thing, but it will take more time, but anyway, no problem. I'll give you 200. Now we have completed everything. Yeah, here we have to give 80. Once again, we have to give. This edge also we have to give 80. That's fine. Then we have given all the pre-mesh parameters. Give pre-mesh. So you can see wonderful mesh will be there. It will be beautiful. Yeah. Yesterday we have put what? Today also I shown how a tetral mesh looks like. But now we can see how a beautiful hexatetral mesh looks like. And if you feel that, sir, how to visualize everything, it is very difficult for me. There's an option. You can go to the parts. You can retain only the fluid center here because that is the name for which the block is there. Okay. You see, when I remove this one, every mesh is gone because there only the mesh is stored. That is the name of the body. So you once again, you highlight it. Then if you want to remove other things, you can remove. So now you can see the mesh is only at where? At the outlet. So now you can check whether the mesh is good or not, like that. Okay, like this you can check. Sir, I want to see what is the outer wall. Yeah, you can see only the outer wall. Got it, what I'm telling? So this is the advantage of naming the components individually. Yesterday also I told you to name them individually and appropriately. And the other thing is the inlet. So inlet also you can check it. So the mesh look is one, but still we are not happy with the determinant. So let us go for the quality check. That is nothing but your Q. So go to Q and check the angle. You see, the angle is, the maximum angle is 90 degree. We are not worried about the maximum angle. We are always worried about the minimum angle. The minimum angle is only 2.376. That is, in your class, there may, if you are a teacher, if you are a professor, in your class, there will be many students who got a 100 out of 100. But the very less mark scored by a student is 2 marks only. But what this particular 18 marks, then only the class is okay, like that is telling. But here you can see the minimum angle is what? We are not happy with 90 degree. We are worried about only 2.376 degree. This 2.376 degree should be increased to what? At least 18 degrees. At least 18 degrees. Then I will check the determinant. In previous case of cube, what is the minimum angle? 90. What is the maximum angle? 90. All the elements are pakka. All elements are 100% good. But here it is not like that. Then determinant 3 by 3. Apply. You can see the here the maximum determinant is also 1, the minimum determinant is also 1. Now we can see the maximum is 1, but the minimum is what? 0.274, which is also not acceptable because the minimum determinant should be what? I told for even for a complex geometry, it should be more than 0.3. This center is not a complex geometry. So this quality can be improved more than 0.3. Similarly, the angle can be improved more than 18 degrees. Okay, this is what I learned at Robert Bosch. When I was working there, they told even for complex geometry, you should be in a position to improve the quality beyond 18 degree and determine beyond what 0.3. Like that, we got the idea. So even though the mesh looks very beautiful, but it's not okay because the angle and determinant are not fine. So anyone can answer me why we are not able to get the angle and determinant? Yes, somebody has a message. To be very specific, Mr. Oscar, I can tell you like this. Oscar has asked a question. You have projected the vertex inside. Now the edges are inside. How it will be able to capture the curve which is outside? Whether I'm right, Mr. Oscar? Whether I'm right, I understand your question.
Yes, sir. That's my question.
Yeah. I got your question. Yeah. Now, even though the edges are looking straight, but it's a curved region, I can put you one more thing for your understanding. Edges, then projected edge shape. You can see now this shape have been merged with the what? The curve. Even though it looks like straight line, but the projected edge shape will become what? Curved one. So no need to worry. Even though Mr. Oscar and other participants, even though the edges look like what? A straight line. But since we have associated these edges to the cylindrical curve, it will try to take the shape of the cylindrical curve. Okay, so nothing to worry for that. So if I'm removing the curves, you can see, yeah, the edges have taken the shape of a cylindrical curve path and not as a straight line. So don't worry about that. Okay, they have written the code in such a way that it will automatically take care of the curve region also. I hope I have answered you. Yeah.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, but don't use that projected shape, edge shape always, because it will take more memory. Because it will take more memory. Okay, fine. Now why I'm not able to get a proper thing is that for cylindrical geometry, it is not possible to get the exact determinant angle by a cube type of or a square prism type of block. So we have to put a O grid block. I will repeat once again. We have now, how many blocks we have now? We have only one block. You see, we have only one block, but this one block is not able to capture the cylinder. Now what I'm going to do means, I'm going to break this single block into five blocks. And the name of the block is going to be called as O-grid. And the name of the block is called as what? O-grid block, C-grid block, L-grid block. Like that, there are number of grids or a number of type of blocks are there. Now what the block we are going to form is called as O-grid. So the O-grid will be having, after doing it, I can show how the O-grid will be there. So for all the participants, I am telling, for doing a meshing for a cylindrical object, you should go for O grid. You should go for the O grid. Wait. Yeah. So when you want to go for the O grid, the methodology is you go to the second button. What is second button? Can anyone tell? It is
split block.
It is split block. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to split the block into number of blocks. So go to this block, click that one. And what is the first one? Split block. But I'm not happy with split block. I'm going to second option. What is second option? O-grid block. So the O-grid block should be always preferred or it should be implemented for the cylindrical object. So definitely we have to go for the O-grid. So I'm going to go for O-grid. Which block I want to do? I want to do the O-grid block for this particular block. Okay, fine. I have chosen the thing and I'm pressing the middle button. After pressing the middle button also, it's not leaving. From which face to which face? So you choose this face, from the front face to the back face. Okay. Then, now also it's not going, give apply. Now what happened? One block is split into five blocks. What are the five blocks? 1, 2, 3, 4, and the center block, five blocks. So totally there are five blocks. If you want to see also, you can see. Got it? First one block, two block, three block, four block, and five block. So totally now we have five blocks. Totally we have five blocks. I will repeat once again for all the participants because some of you may have doubts. I will explain you once again. So once again, I made as a single block. All of you can see there's only one block. But my intention is that since it's a cylindrical object, the single block may not be sufficient to capture the required quality of the mesh. And hence, I want to create a O-grid. The O-grid is nothing but a process of breaking a single block into five blocks as follows. So how to do it? Go to blocking tree. Go to blocking. Don't choose the first one. First one is for creating a new block. So I'm using the second block. It's split block. In that also, don't use the first one. It's also split block. You choose the second one. Because the second one is nothing but what? Your O-grid block. So choose the second block. Select the blocks. In our case, there's only one block. But when you're going to do a complex geometry, you may have a number of blocks. But you have to choose a block for which you want the O-grid. Okay? So only you are given blocks. So I'm choosing the block for which I want the O-grid. After this, I have to choose a face. Which face? This one. First of all, you have to click with the leftmost button, this one, plus. This left one, this from the front face to the back face. Then press the middle button. Then also it's not okay. Then give apply. Now what happened? The single block has been split into five blocks. if I'm going to give you front or front, you know, left. Yeah, you can see. Now the single block is split into what? Five blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now let us try to give the angle and determinant. Now I'm going to give the pre-mesh parameters. I'm going to give this parameter because other things are already given. This is already given. This is already given. And this is also already given. Okay. So only left out is what? The diagonal edges. Now this diagonal edges, the length is 15 mm. The length is what? 15 mm. So I'm going to give some, say 45 or even 50, nothing wrong. And I'm going to give, you see, I'm going to give here, here spacing 1, I am going to give 0.001. And the ratio is what? 1.1. And I'm going to give apply. When I given like this, please all of you listen here. What I given, I will repeat it once again so that everyone understands. So I go into the pre-mesh parameters. I am going to choose this edge. Yeah, I have chosen. And I given 15, the length is 15 already. I given the number of nodes to be 50, 50. After that, until now I have not done anything. But when I come into this diagonal element alone, what I did means I go into the spacing 1. There I have given as 0.001. And I given the ratio as 1.1. What does it mean is that the first cell element is at 0.001 mm from the wall. So you can see here, so this distance is nothing but your 0.001 mm. Okay. So this much of mm is the first cell. The second cell will be this value into 1.1. So the mesh length will increase. It will grow. It is the growth ratio. This value will be bigger than this value by 1.1. This element will be what? More than this value by 1.1. That is called the growth ratio. That is called the growth ratio. Now I hope you got the logic. Why I have chosen spacing 1 and not spacing 2 is that I'll tell you once again. You see here, whenever there's a arrow head like this, the bigger one indicates 1. The pointed one indicates the 2. I'll repeat you once again. Whenever you are showing the edges, you can see a black arrow is there. The wider end or the bigger end corresponds to the spacing 1. And the pointed end or the conical end corresponds to the spacing 2. Here I want more fine mesh near to the wall in order to capture the boundary layer. I have given very fine mesh to the wall. And I have given what? Coarse mesh towards the core. Why? The gradient will not be much more than in the center, where the gradient will be much more at the wall. So in order to capture the better physics, here I have played with the meshing. I have not given the uniform mesh. Since I am more expertized now, I know I have to capture the boundary layer from the walls. The mesh near the wall should be more, which is means more means it is finer. And the mesh near to the center part of the flow of the cylinder, where the gradients will not be more. Gradients means the changes will not be more. There I can go with what? Some coarser mesh. And hence I made the mesh to be somewhat bigger or coarser. And I have made like this. Any doubt in how to create the O-grid and how to specify the values as per to capture the boundary layers? Any doubts? Whether I have to repeat once again?
Sir, one question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, when you are using...
The question should be limited to what I have taught you. It's not going
further.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It is related to this only, sir.
Yeah.
So when you divided block into using O-grid, it has taken 5 blocks.
Yeah.
Have you given constraints only to 5 blocks or automatically it has taken 5 blocks?
It will automatically split into 5 blocks. We can't create into 5 blocks. It will automatically take into 5 blocks.
What is the reason the system is built up to 5 blocks, sir?
No, I want to create diagonals. Automatically it will end up with center block also. Nah? So when I'm going to split in the 4 corners, it will become end. 4 diagonals will come. So automatically we'll have 4 blocks at the end. But center also we should have 1 block. So we will end up with 5 blocks.
Okay, it is only for the cylinder geometry, or if you choose
only
any other geometry?
Only for the cylinder geometry, you need to put O-grid block. For all other things, we don't want to go grid block.
Okay.
For a normal geometry, there's no need for O grid block. Even for the cube, I have not put any O grid. That is very, very simple block. Okay, I am going step by step. Okay, I will repeat once again before others who understood, but it's better for all to tell. For the person who has a doubt, you please listen very carefully. It's very simple, nothing to worry. And now the first point is I want to split the single block into five blocks by putting a O grid in order to enhance the angle and the determinant. For that, what I'm going to go to blocking, go to split block, go to the split block, second option, choose the block, this one, and choose the face from where to where, from this face to this face. You apply. Now the single block will be split into what? Five blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, then I don't know where you have the doubt, whether you have the doubt in creating the O grid or specifying the mesh parameters, I don't know, but I will repeating once again very fastly. Now we go to this pre-mesh parameters, you give this pre-mesh parameter. Now the length of the edge is only 15 mm, but I am going to give 50 mm for namesake. Sir, how you are given 50 means? I don't know. Simply I have given 50. If you want, you can give 60. You can give even 30. Nothing wrong in that. Simply, I am giving some 50 or 60. There is no general thumb rule. But my intention is that I want to put a very fine grid near to the wall. Where is the wall now? Here is the wall. This is the wall. This is not the wall. Here the flow is going to happen. So the wall is here. So I want to put a very fine grid here and maybe close the grid over here. So how to ensure a fine grid at this region and a coarse grid at this region? So to ensure that, what is the spacing? I will remove the surface. What is the spacing I am going to give? You see, the already the spacing is 0 only, but I am going to give 0.001. And ratio also I am going to give either 1.1 or 1.2, but I am going to give 1.1. I am going to give apply. The idea is that, if so you may have a doubt, sir, there is a spacing 2 also, whether it type there somewhere. No, not required. Because the wider end of the triangle is the spacing 1. The sharpened end or the corner end or the triangular end is the spacing 2. So I want to give very fine grid here only. Which means when I'm going to zoom it, I can tell this distance is what? This is the first mesh count or the first node. So this distance will be 0.001 mm. So what about the distance between this node and this node? This is 0.001 into 1.1. So it will be slightly bigger, this one. Similarly, this will be what? This value into 1.1. So like that, it will proceed. I hope I have answered you. If you are unable to still understand, nothing wrong in that, you may call me separately. I will try to teach you. Okay. But it's a very easy one. It's not difficult. So I give the pre-mesh. You can see now how the mesh looks like. Have everybody seen? Okay, like this we are done. And fine. Even though there may be a problem. Yeah, fine. What I want to show is that outlet will remove. We'll remove the outlet also. Yeah. Okay, I'll put in this view. Can you see? This is the one which is nothing but 0.001. This is 0.001 into 1.1. We can see that is a very fine mesh near to the wall in order to capture the boundary layer. And the mesh grows in size as it goes to the core or as it goes to the center. This methodology is called as capturing the boundary layer. So the mesh should not be uniform. Don't feel that your mesh should be always uniform. The mesh can be uniform for the analysis. But the mesh should not be uniform when you are having the boundary layer effects. Okay. Here, don't confuse this as prism layer. All the hexahedral mesh are good only. All the hexahedral mesh are what? Hexahedral only. They are not called as prism. Meshes are called as what? They are 3D elements with the hexahedral. Okay. So nothing to worry. These meshes are called as what? Hexahedral mesh. All elements are hexahedral. Not even a single mesh is what? Tetrahedral. That is the concept. Okay. I hope you got the idea. And now let us check with the Still, I hope the quality will not be improved, or let us check, because I given a very fine mesh. That may be the reason. Let us see. Yeah, still the angle is not good, because the problem is when I'm trying to give in this direction, I have to give in the other direction also. Otherwise, this problem of determinant will come. So not only putting a O grid, but also to specify the boundary mesh parameters clearly. So I'll go here and I'll try to type here. Instead of 0.001, I will limit myself to now 0.1 and give OK. And give replot. Give accept. Give yes. Yeah, now you can see. You see the beauty. Now the mesh quality is improved from what? 0.23 to 0.91. So by means of putting an O grid, you are able to improve the determinant of the mesh from 0.023 to what? 0.91. So there are not even a single element with a determinant less than 0.91. That is, you should not be happy with the determinant alone. You have to go for the angle also. So go to the angle. So angle, give apply. So the angle is also improved from what? Less than 80 degree to what? 45.72. Why we are having 45.72 means this angle will become 45 because we are making that angle. So we can't further improve beyond 45 or certain angle. So it is 45. So we can see the angle also has improved from less than 80 degree to even is not less than 80 degree. It is 2.37 degree. Now from 2.73 we have raised to what? 45.72. So this is the advantage of the O grid. So whenever there's a cylindrical object, you should ensure definitely to put a O grid. The O grid will help you to improve the quality of the mesh and the determinant and the angle. So with this, we have completed all the mesh for the cylindrical object. If you want, you can see the other components also, like you can remove the inlet, we can see the outer wall. The outer wall will not have much difference because it will be same. Once again, the outlet also will be same as the inlet. Once again, you can convert the pre-mesh into what? Convert transaction mesh. Now only we are converting into the mesh. Once the quality and determinant are good only, we have to go for the converting into the unstructured mesh. So I hope we can stop here because already it crossed 110. Maybe another 2 to 3 minutes I'll end up. Maybe we'll start by 3 o'clock. Or
yes, sir.
I will try to go to the city and buy that graphics tablet and come back so that in the afternoon we may have our class through that graphics tablet. And I have ordered 1 week back, but still I'm unable to receive it. Unable to communicate to you properly. Okay. So now the mesh is formed. You can see the cells also. If you want to see the cells, yeah. You can put the inlet, then you can see the cells. After this, there's no need of this one. Yeah, file, save project as, we can give as what? Cylinder, I can put as a cylinder, I can put as a cylinder, et cetera. So I can give name as what? Now, if the tin file, then you will save the block file. The file is the block file. Then you will save the UNS file also, dot UNS, meshing file. Yeah, dot UNS. .prg is also there. Once this is done,
I hope he lost the connection.
participants, we can reassemble here for an meet in the 3 o'clock for the next section. Thank you.
Sorry, is there any specific material that you need?
Sir, sir, your network is very slow. So we can take a break, sir. After taking the break, 3 o'clock we can meet. Sir, after taking a break, we can join, sir. Sir, after taking the break, we can join. Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yeah.